Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to get geeky. This is for sound designers or aspiring sound designers who want to create their own sound kit. So this video is going to be from scratch, how to build your own drum kit and also how to edit existing sounds so that they sound different and transformative to include in your packs. So firstly, let's go to the channel rack. We're going to load up a plugin here. We're going to right click and replace this with Serum. So there are, you know, let's say what is in a drum kit. You have a kick, a hi-hat, and a snare for the most part, and 808s. So hopefully I'll do this in one take, depending on the time of the day here, but we'll probably have to split this into parts. So let's focus on kicks today. We're going to switch here the voicing to basic shapes. Now, I recommend you guys use the sine wave, but the analog sine wave has more harmonics, it's called. Okay, so let's use that version, and we're going to lower the octave. So the key to a kick drum is not only the decay curvature. So right now, if I hold the note, it just plays a note and it keeps going. So this request is from produced by Jet on our Instagram broadcast channel. So shout out to him. We're going to pull back what's called sustain so that the sound has a decay curvature. So now when we hit a note, it goes ding, it decays, it dies out. Okay, so what I like to do when I'm designing kicks is I'll add these notes in the channel rack and just hit play, so I can hear what it sounds like in real time. So the first thing is just getting the right octave. Firstly, we're gonna lower the octave to 2. I wish it were easy where we could just type in a hertz value. The hertz you wanna focus on is 60 and 75 hertz. That's your magic zone when it comes to your kick. But for now, we're just gonna do it by ear. So octave 2 is kind of where we're gonna start. Now, by default, Serum adds an attack curvature to the sound, so it adds this little click depending on the attack time. So we don't necessarily want that click. So that little blip you guys hear, that's from the attack time. Let's pull this up so we don't hear that. Okay, so the next thing we want to do is create a separate envelope. Let's go to envelope 2. We're going to pull down the sustain and drag this over what's called the coarse pitch. The coarse pitch so that the pitch dives very quickly. So it goes ew, like that. So a lot of EDM kicks have a longer pitch curvature. Okay, so you hear that pitch dive, but in hip hop, we don't hear the pitch dive because the decay curvature is a lot faster. I'll exaggerate. Okay, so that's what's happening to the pitches. It's slowly going down, but let's make this decay curvature faster. Now to give you guys numbers, 500 milliseconds is a very long time. You want to think in terms of 70 milliseconds. Anything under 100 is probably where you guys want to focus on. And this is where the knock comes from in the kick. So when people tell me you can add knock with a plugin, you know, they're not really being transparent. Okay, so let's add envelope 2. And we're going to switch this to FM from B because we want to add harmonics to our kick. Harmonics, if you guys struggle with sound design, let's hit Control L, send the sound to the mixer. Let's open a plugin here called Wave Candy, because in this plugin, it will show us, different things. Let's right click, go to spectrum mode. We're going to turn the resolution pretty high, and you can turn the scale higher to see lower frequencies a little bit easier. So here's what our kick is doing right now. It's just starting at a high pitch, going to a low pitch over time, and then it's just sitting there. So if you guys notice, it has these horizontal lines. You might not be able to see, but those horizontal lines are called harmonics. So we need to add more harmonics or horizontal lines for this sound to feel like it's hitting harder. Okay, so let's go to oscillator B now. And this, we don't want this to be audible, so let's turn the level down. We're gonna switch this to a sine wave. And all we want to do here is FM from B. So if I turn this up, we get like a texture sound. Okay, but we only want this sound to occur in a very short amount of time. Let's drag the envelope 2 over top of the pointer and give it a small range here to add that boxy tone to the kick. Okay, so now we have, that boxy tone. So again, I like to hear the kick in context. Now, before we go further, most people don't understand that the kick gets its knock from the processing, not the sound design most of the time. Okay, so let's run this kick through a plugin called, where is it at here? Standard Clip. And this will add the saturation we need on the kick to really knock. So let's push the kick through here. Let's give it some volume here. And now we can hear some of the kick. We can really hear that crunch. So now we got to go back to the actual sound and start shaping the sound, because right now the kick is just not really formed. So let's pull back some of the FM. And also too, we can add a filter to kind of chisel out some of those higher frequencies. We could add drive to add more. We're basically taking the sine wave and squaring it off into more of a pulse wave. This will create more harmonics, but we're losing the boom of the sound. So you got to be careful with any drive. Okay, so now we have the shape of the kick tonally. Now we're just going to go to the envelope because the kick's too long. So now we just determine how long do we want the kick to be. And if you want to get deeper with it, you can add a sub oscillator here to add like more tone to the kick. That's for more like Timbaland type kicks. We're not going to do that right now though. So once I have that recorded, once I have that set, we're gonna go inside the mixer channel here. We're gonna open up Edison. So I have a whole sound design course. If you guys didn't know, I teach you guys how to build your own drum kit from scratch. Every single step, hi-hats, claps, snares, kicks, 808s. Let's record on play. We're gonna hit record, and then when we hit play, it will record whatever it hears from the channel rack. So now we have our kick. We're gonna hit stop. Let's just double click where it says song jump, drag the dragon copy, drag it back into Edison. And now we can see what the kick looks like. So let's right click delete. And you can compare this with any other kick sample that you guys have and start to see similarities. So the only difference here is that it's not its loudest form. And now we can analyze the kick. So we can see that it goes down. So that's our amp envelope. It goes down in volume. We can see the fast frequencies, which are closer together. And then it goes to longer, wider spaces. That means we're going from higher frequencies to lower frequency. And we can see it's a sine wave by the curvature here. We could also tell in the beginning, we have squaring off of the sine wave, which tells us that we have some kind of distortion or some kind of saturation that squares off that sound. And that's how we get the knock in the beginning of the kick. We don't want the knock in the entire kick because that will destroy the boom. So all we have to do now is just turn this kick up. In FL's Edison, we could just drag the sides out and normalize the sound. And now we have a nice loud kick. So to save this, we're going to go to the save icon, save sample as, and just save this wherever you guys, you know, have your sounds. We'll put it in my sounds folder. And where'd it go? Here it is. So now we can right click, open a new channel. Okay, so now we have a kick. So now we have to determine what do we want to change about the kick. Maybe the tuning, so we could lower the pitch range and just crank it up. Now we have a super hard kick. So I would recapture that. Let's put this into channel 2. We're not going to run it through standard clip. We're just going to open up Edison, hit new, record on play. Okay, so it sounded way harder. I don't know why it sounded quieter. That's weird. Okay. So let me just play the normal. I'm trying to figure out why it's tuning it down. Oh, okay, we're not playing middle C. That was my mistake. All right, so we are playing G5. So my kick sounds better as G5 than C. So I'm going to record that tuning as well. So let's record in Edison. On play. All right, so now we have two versions of the kick, one played at C, one played at G5. Sometimes you get a better frequency response. We're just gonna right click, delete these, and normalize it so it's loud. And then save this. We'll call this sound design kick 2. That's how I sound design. I like make small tweaks until I can't tweak the sound, and then I'll start back over. So sound design kick 2. So now we have two different kicks. Refresh. We can hear one's more low frequency based, but it doesn't have as much knock. The other one has a lot more knock, but it doesn't have as much low frequency. So now I can go in and say, okay, how do we maximize the both world, the best of both worlds? So let's fix this so it's not doing that. Boom. Okay, so now we have this kick. Now, and by default, they turn the volume down in the channel rack. So that's, we got to turn it back up with this channel volume here. So now what I'll do to make my final edit is pull up an EQ, and here we're just going to, because it's more, this kick knocks more, I just want to enhance some of the frequencies that give it the sub rumble. Here's where I'm going to look for 60 hertz, 75 hertz. Usually I just look at whatever's closer to the energy source here, which is 60. 75 is not as close. And just boost this until you hear it. Now we're clipping, so we need to watch the output levels here. So I'm going to boost this until my ear hears it. My ear doesn't hear this yet. Okay, there we go. And that's the feeling to the kick. That's probably a little too much. So let's say, let's cut that in half. Let's do 3.5. Okay, so now the kick is more rounded and more boomy. And then I might run this through like some sound of saturation. But see how if we saturate the sound too much, it turns into a square wave and it sounds thin. So this is the final version. Let's record this on play. All right, and now we have our final mutation, so to speak. And that's how I sound design. I don't sound design one time and then cut everything. You guys got to sound design in parts. So let's normalize. And then now we can save this as, all right, so that's my real process on how I sound design. Let's refresh this and let's hear all these back to back. So we have sound design kick one, kick two, and then kick three. I'll just play these on loop. So the loudest one is kick three. It has the most energy. All right, so it's as simple as that. If you guys want to learn more about how to create hi-hats, snares, claps, kicks, 808s, make your own drum kits from scratch, go to busyworksbeats.com/premium. I have a sound design course for you guys. And we have a 14-day free trial for those who want to just hop in, get straight to it. We have 68 music production courses, so you guys have a lot to choose from. But that's how you make your own sound kit. Subscribe if you're new. Like this video. Peace.